you get this book? There's a copy of this at his friend's giving me. It's got Sylvia on the front. Anyway, I don't know whether you read that section on music inside. I thought it was a really good section, and sometimes you wonder why you do music, but I thought I'd just read this paragraph to you, if you haven't read this paragraph, the first paragraph. According to a recent University of Michigan national poll on health and aging, 98% of older adults say they benefit from music in some way. 98%. The most common benefit is stress relief or relaxation. The other bonus is mental health, mood, and attitude. Music can also help older adults feel less isolated and more connected. In addition, music can stimulate the brain and help keep it engaged. Music improvisation, which is what we do, can enhance memory as well. It's also a fact that music can improve breathing, lower blood pressure, and reduce heart rate. Music aids muscle relaxation and bone density. And believe it or not, music can also invoke strong emotions and bring back memories, provided we express yourself. We're probably going to bring back some memories for you in 1964, but Rick will talk about that. I just thought I'd read that to you because that's why we do it.
That's right, it's all 1964.
We know we're not going to Hollywood anymore. We're just trying to enjoy ourselves and have some fun.
Speak for yourself. Hello, everybody. We're Patients at Fortitude. We're going to play for you today, and we're glad to be back. We're going to do something a little special today. We're going to take you back in time for 60 years. We're going from 2024 to the year 1964, and we're going to play all songs from 1964. It was really a great year for music, and most of you are probably alive back then. So hope you hear some songs that you remember. And the first thing we're going to start off with, actually the biggest thing about 1964 was it was the year that the Beatles came to the United States and were on the Ed Sullivan Show. How many people saw the Beatles on the Ed Sullivan Show? Okay. Yeah, that was a big mark. So we got to start off with a song that the Beatles played on the Ed Sullivan Show. So here we go.
One, two, three. She loves you, yeah.
She loves you, yeah. She loves you, yeah. And you lost your love when I saw her yesterday.
Okay, now there's a lot of great American groups who had songs in 1964. And some of them were famous groups or artists who had a lot of songs. Some of them were just like one-hit wonders. This is a song by a group called The Reflections. And the song is called Just Like Romeo and Juliet.
Yeah, great dances.
That'd be nice.
Everybody dancing this, right?
Okay. Yeah.
It's in C, right?
Yeah.
How do we start this song? I kind of forget.
Record, it helps if your manager is the same manager as the Beatles in 1964. And there's a group called Billy J. Kramer and the Dakotas, who was from Liverpool. And their manager was Brian Epstein, who was the manager of the Beatles. And So the Beatles, so he got the Beatles to write a song for Billy J. and the Dakotas. And it's called Bad to Me. It's by, it was written by John and Paul, and it goes like this. You guys ready?
Yep, ready.
If you ever leave me, I'll be sad and blue. Don't you ever leave me, I'm so in love with you. The birds in the sky would be sad and lonely. The sky. 1964, the Four Seasons were already an established group. And they had a lot of hits before that, like Big Girls Don't Cry and Sherry. But they did have a hit in 1964, and it was called Dawn Go Away.
And my wife keeps telling me not to sing this song. Make sure that I'm in the seat. Sorry, Don. Pretty as a midsummer dream, they call her
Sullivan Show, like I said, in February, and every month after, Ed Sullivan had another English group on, and in March he had the Dave Clark Five, and April it was the Searchers, and in May it was a group called Jerry and the Pacemakers, who were from Liverpool, too, and they had the time, they had a song called Don't Let the Sun Catch You Crying that we're going to play now. That's why this is a 1964. It's Johnny Rivers version. Okay.
Cause
kind of going on in the early 60s about tragedy songs where people would, you know, get in car crashes and all that kind of stuff. And it kind of faded out by 1964. The Beatles kind of changed a lot. But in 1964, there was a song called The Last Kiss by J. Frank Wilson and the Cavaliers.
As I remember those days, I just got to throw something in. I remember those days, there were so many people got killed in car crashes back in the 60s. We were just waiting for the phone to ring, knowing who was going to be next. I can name probably 10 of our local
Town
people got killed in car crashes. Maniacs, but, and they took a lot of the people. Sometimes it wasn't just them, but sometimes it was other people. Several of them people died in the accident. Yeah. No seatbelts.
So
cars were pretty fast.
Drive carefully when you go home today. Keep a watch out in the parking lot. It's pretty crowded. Okay, ready?